Good evening students, we have already completed plant tissue. Now we are starting animal tissues. So there are different types of animal tissues. I have told you difference between animal tissues and plant tissue. Again in next video we are going to discuss that also, difference between animal tissue and plant tissue. Now if we are talking about animal tissue, in this I am going to give you the classification of animal tissue. Okay, so if we are talking about animal tissue, depending on its function, okay, depending upon its function, animal tissues are classified into four types: epithelial tissue, next is connective tissue, nervous tissue, and muscular tissue. Okay, now epithelial tissue is again classified on the basis of its shape. Okay, on the basis of its shape and arrangement, epithelial tissues can further be classified. Now it is of different types: squamous. Squamous by name only, it is clear that these are square in shape. Next is cuboidal. Cuboidal epithelial tissue, it means they are cuboid in shape. Now next is columnar epithelial tissue. Okay, columnar, so these are rectangular in shape, or we can say they are in the shape of column. Next is ciliated. Now ciliated means cilia, that is hair like structure, is present. And last is glandular tissue. Okay, glandular. Glandular means they function as a gland. They secrete the secretion. They secrete fluid. Okay, so these are different types of epithelial tissues, and these types are on the basis of their shape and arrangement. Next is connective tissue. By name only, it is clear that the function of connective tissue is to connect different organs. Okay, means it helps in attachment or connectivity. So different types of connective tissues are, it may be in the form of fluid or liquid, that is blood, clear. Next, it may be dense, okay, dense connective tissue. So in dense connective tissue, again there are two types: tendons and ligament. These are two types of dense connective tissue. Next is areolar tissue. Areolar means air space is present. Okay, it is present between the space of internal organ. Next is adipose tissue. Adipose tissue, it helps in deposition of fats. Okay, and last is skeletal tissue. Skeletal tissue, you all are familiar. It gives shape to the cell. It forms skeleton. Okay. So skeletal tissues are mainly of how many types? Two types. They are cartilaginous and bone. Okay. They are cartilage and bone. Now, these are different types of connective tissues on the basis of their function. It is divided into different types. Nervous tissue, there is no further classification. And last is muscular tissue. Okay, so muscular tissues are of three types. That is striated tissues, unstriated tissues, and cardiac muscular tissue. Okay, striated means striation, or we can say light and dark color band is present. Unstriated means light and dark color band is absent. Okay, in striated tissue, this light and dark color bands are present. In next session, I'm going to show you the actual images also. So with the help of that, you can easily observe different types of tissues. Okay. So with the help of, even you will be able to differentiate between different types of tissues. So on the basis of its structure, function, it is of three types: striated, light and dark bands present; unstriated, light and dark bands are absent. Okay. Or we can say smooth. Cardiac, it has a very peculiar function, that it contracts and relax rhythmically. Okay, it contracts and relax rhythmically, and it is present in the heart. We all know that heart functions continuously from the birth till death. The whole life, it is the muscle which functions from the time of birth till death, means you can say for the whole time without taking any rest. So this is the muscle which works continuously. Okay, and it is present in the heart. So in animal tissue, there are mainly four types of tissues: epithelial, connective, nervous and muscular tissue. And after that, epithelial tissue is further classified into different types on the basis of its shapes and arrangement. They are squamous epithelium tissue, cuboidal epithelial tissue, columnar epithelial tissue, ciliated epithelial tissue, and glandular epithelial tissue. Then after that, connective tissue. It is further divided into different types on the basis of its function: fluid connective tissue, that is blood; dense connective tissue, that is tendons and ligaments; areolar tissue; adipose tissue; and skeletal tissue. Skeletal tissue is further classified into cartilage and bone. And nervous tissue means, we all know, it is a nerve cells. Okay, and it is, nerve cell has a peculiar function and structure. It conveys the message from one part of the body to the other. On the response of these nerve cells only, we are able to reply or convey message. Okay. And after that, muscular tissue. Muscular tissue is further divided into three types: cardiac, striated, unstriated. Clear?